Hey, so the topic of today's video is vulnerability and authenticity in marketing. And I want to talk to you about why your vulnerability and your transparency are your best tools for selling specifically from stage. So I just opened up this care package and these amazing shoes are in this care package. And this is a sign from the universe that I'm supposed to make this video. So let me back up for a moment and then I'll tell you the story about the shoes. A few weeks ago, there I was on stage at one of my biggest Women's Leadership Summit live events ever. We had over 400 women in the room. And one of the things I do at those events is I debrief the offer. Now that might sound really scary, but I find it to be one of the best tools that I have for selling, to have a very real conversation in the room about, you know, what happened for you when I make the offer on stage for, you know, a $10,000 year-long training program. Do you want it? Do you not want it? Do you hate me? Are you triggered? Do you think I'm a slimy salesperson, school teacher from Iowa, right? And I love hearing the responses that come out in the room, and I love having a real discussion about what's actually going on for people. So I make the inquiry Sunday morning after my offer, and this girl's hand shoots up. And she gets the microphone, and, you know, like a very courageous, strong woman who, you know, is very wise, she says, I heard before I even came to this event that you were going to make a pitch. And I had made a decision before I even came that I wasn't going to buy anything. So when you made the offer yesterday, you know, I wasn't surprised, but I was a little bit like, you know, I was getting the thing that I expected to get. And she was justifiably kind of poking at the fact that I had just stood on stage in front of all of these people and made this big offer and kind of testing me on it.
So I'm scared to say anything because I'm pretty sure you're gonna convince me to do the program.
Well, and I promise to not do that. Okay, I lied.
You know, and she had every right to do so. I had asked her to do so. But I was a little bit intimidated. You know, I was on stage going, oh crap, how am I going to handle this in front of everybody? And every once in a while when I'm leading on stage, I'll hear a voice in the back of my head that says, bring her up on stage. And I'm always like, oh God, I'm going to bring this person up on stage. But that happened. And so I said to Melanie, would you like to come up on stage? And she's like, of course. So she gets up there like the little badass she is, and she's got bare feet on. And, you know, she's like, is it okay if I come on your stage with bare feet?
I don't need shoes, do I?
No, you don't need shoes.
And I had actually been teaching barefoot for most of the weekend. So I kicked off my shoes and I said, of course, you know, my stage is open to all bare feet. And she comes up, and what was so interesting was that, you know, she was ready to have a breakthrough around sales and being made an offer. And I still didn't quite know how I was going to facilitate it. So she gets up on stage and she's really grappling with her sort of distaste for the offer that I had just made. Like, she had a reaction, she didn't really like it. And, you know, that's completely legitimate that she didn't like it. And she was brave enough to come up on stage and express that. And she had a gift that she wanted to bring to the world.
I mean, what I know is that I'm a teacher and a performer, and I like the idea of feeling good and helping other people feel good. Like, that's
beautiful, beautiful.
And she admitted that she didn't quite know how to bring it. And so in order for her to experience the offer from a different perspective, what we did was we helped her experience her own offer for the world from a different place. And by the time she got off that stage, she had the entire audience in tears. I mean, it was beautiful. We took her from the place of just being like, ew, I just got sold to standing on stage and claiming that she wants to help people really understand their value. She's here to support people to wake up around this very topic of money and being underprivileged. At one point,
my heels were laying on stage, like right in front of her. I asked her, she was having this breakthrough around money and materialism and owning your power. And at one, I just said, why don't you try on my heels? So she put them on and she looked so cute in them. Now, these are the most comfortable heels ever. They're more like platform shoes. And she looked so cute in the heels that before she got off of stage, I said to her, you know what? You look so great in those shoes. Why don't you just keep them? And the whole audience got quiet. And she looked at me and she said, you're giving me your shoes? And I said, sure, of course. Of course I'll give you my shoes.
Do you want these?
Seriously?
Do you want them?
What, seriously?
Do you like them?
I really like them. Are you giving me your shoes?
Do you want them?
I do. They're really
They're really nice shoes.
And after she got off the stage, I want to be totally honest, I had some giver's remorse because those were my favorite heels. So here's the amazing takeaway of the whole thing. Not even a couple weeks later, I get a care package from a woman named Jessica Silverman. These shoes are the exact same shoes I gave Melanie on stage to help facilitate this breakthrough around making offers and materialism and glam, right? These shoes were Jessica's. She had worn them exactly twice. And she was so touched by what happened on stage that she said, I have to send you these shoes. I don't even like them that much. Clearly you love the shoes. They're the exact same size. And look, they're like brand new with little lavender sachets inside of them. So Jessica, I've been wearing your shoes. Thank you so much. You'll all be proud to know that Melanie, the gal that had the breakthrough on stage and that was all anti, like, you know, you made this pitch and, you know, I didn't even know if I wanted to come and I was totally ready for you to make the pitch. And she had like this whole breakthrough around me making an offer on stage. She went to the back of the room and signed up for the program. And so did 100 other women in the room who are now studying with us. And it's my great honor to serve them this year. And I want to just be completely transparent. For those of us that make offers from stage, it is edgy. It's edgy for the one making the offer. And it's edgy for the ones in the seat that really want the support. And the more we can bring authenticity and vulnerability and magic and realness into the offers that we make on behalf of our business, the more lives we're going to be able to change. Because this is just about you changing lives. That's all it's about. And how dare you hold back and fear that people are gonna judge you for being salesy when you actually have something inside you that will change their lives. And yet we hold back all the time. So this is my stake in the ground. That you continue to get out of your own way and make your commitment to give your gift and change lives bigger than your fear of making the offer. And if at any point you stumble and you're not quite sure what to do, just give them your shoes. Thank you, Jessica Silverman, for the shoes. Thank you, Melanie, for letting us support you this year. It's going to be an incredible year. Thank you for being on this journey of authentic, womanly entrepreneurship with me. Tell me your aha moment about sales and making offers from stage below. Let's get a comment thread going. I love you and I bless you, and your clients are waiting for you. You!